हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज़ प्रोफेसर जाधव पीएल। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द वाटर प्रूफिंग, डैम प्रूफिंग कोर्सेस एंड प्लिंथ प्रोटेक्शन एंड नेसेसिटी ऑफ द प्लिंथ प्रोटेक्शन। ओके, सो फर्स्ट वन इज़ अ वाटर प्रूफिंग। सो रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द कंस्ट्रक्शन टू द लीकेज ऑफ वाटर इज नोन एज अ वाटर प्रूफिंग। रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द कंस्ट्रक्शन टू द लीकेज ऑफ द वाटर इज नोन एज अ वाटर प्रूफिंग। Basic requirement of all the buildings are that the structure should remain dry as far as possible. If the condition is not satisfied, it is likely that the building may become inhabitable and unsafe from the structural point of view. Hence, in order to prevent the entry and the exit of the water from the construction, waterproofing treatment is necessary. Okay. So waterproofing maintenance the appearance of the building and increase the life of the structure. New building rarely suffer from the leakage through the waterproofing, but as the structure becomes older, it settles unevenly, forms cracks in the wall, and the leakage is formed. Okay, so for the better waterproofing work, the selection of the quality of the material and workmanship is important. To prevent the entry or exit of the water from the construction, waterproofing treatment is necessary. Moisture and humidity seeps into the interior and causing the significant damage to the so it is very important to avoid the moisture and humidity. No waterproofing can lead to development of the cracks and paint peel off and even molds and mildew. It can also be create a structure and foundation reinforcement corrosion, and then the life of structure reduces. They also develop a musty smell which gradually increases, making it difficult for the inhabitants. Not only for the building, it can also create a health problem for the inhabitants. So it is very important to choose the best waterproofing to protect the structure and healthy life. Okay, the waterproofing je leakage hot asto, water che je leakage hot asto kiwa seepage hot asto, किंवा जी वॉटरची जी एंट्री होत असते, मॉइश्चर किंवा वॉटरची जी एंट्री होत असते ती आपण प्रिव्हेंट करतो, ती आपण रेजिस्ट करतो, त्याला आपण वॉटरप्रूफिंग म्हणतो. तर याची गरज आपल्याला का भासते? जर आपण जर ही एंट्री जर प्रिव्हेंट नाही केली तर बरेचसे प्रॉब्लेम त्या स्ट्रक्चरमध्ये येऊ शकतात, क्रॅक्स किंवा डॅमेज होऊ शकतं बरंच. ठीक आहे, तर ते टाळण्यासाठी आपण वॉटरप्रूफिंग त्याच्यामध्ये करत असतो. Okay, for the better waterproofing work, the selection of the quality of material and workmanship is important. Changla quality cha waterproofing karnyasathi apan changla quality cha material use kela pahije. Ok, waterproofing material are the subdivided by the purpose into the anti-seepage, anti-corrosion, and by the basic material into the asphalt and mineral plastic and metallic. वेगवेगळ्या प्रकारच्या मटेरियल याच्यामध्ये यूज केले जातात, जसं की ॲस्फाल्ट मटेरियल, मिनरल वॉटरप्रूफिंग मटेरियल, प्लास्टिक वॉटरप्रूफिंग मटेरियल, असे वेगवेगळ्या प्रकारचे मटेरियल याच्यामध्ये यूज केले जातात. ओके, नेक्स्ट आपल्याला पाहायचे प्लिंथ प्रोटेक्शन किंवा प्लिंथ प्रोटेक्शनची काय रिक्वायरमेंट असते. प्लिंथ प्रोटेक्शन इज रिक्वायर्ड टू अवॉइड द रिड्यूस वॉटर सीपेज इन द अर्थ रिचिंग द प्लिंथ वॉल अँड रिचेस द फ्लोअर लेवल बाय कॅपिलरी ॲक्शन. प्लिंथ प्रोटेक्शनची रिक्वायरमेंट यासाठी असते की अर्थमधून किंवा ग्राउंडमधून जे काही कॅपिलरी ॲक्शनमुळं जी वॉटरची एंट्री होणार असते वॉलमध्ये, ते आपल्याला प्रिव्हेंट करण्यासाठी त्या ठिकाणी आपल्याला प्लिंथ प्रोटेक्शनची रिक्वायरमेंट असते. द हॉरिझॉन्टल प्रोजेक्शन कोर्स ऑफ अ स्टोन ऑर द ब्रिक प्रोव्हाइड्स ॲट द बेस ऑफ द वॉल अबव द ग्राउंड लेवल इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ प्लिंथ. प्लिंथ रेजेस द लेवल ऑफ द ग्राउंड फ्लोअर अबव द नॅचरल ग्राउंड लेवल सो ॲज टू प्रोटेक्ट द बिल्डिंग फ्रॉम द रेन वॉटर अँड फ्रॉस्ट. टू प्रोटेक्ट द प्लिंथ वॉल फ्रॉम द वेदरिंग इफेक्ट पॉइंटिंग वर्क इज डन बाय रिच मॉर्टर. ओके, सो प्लिंथ मेक्स द एनक्लोजर फॉर द ग्राउंड फ्लोअर इन विच द रबल आर केप्ड आर ओवर अँड अदर एंड कॉम्पॅक्टेड विद इन द मुरुम फिलिंग. ओके, सो प्लिंथ रिक्वायर्ड गुड अँड हार्ड फाउंडेशन सो एज टू प्रिव्हेंट इट फ्रॉम द सेटलमेंट. मटेरियल विच आर रिक्वायर्ड टू प्रोटेक्ट द प्लिंथ आर द रबल्स दॅट इज स्टोन्स, ब्रिक्स, कॉन्क्रीट, सिमेंट मॉर्टर एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. द आर सी सी प्लिन बीम इज यूज वेन द ब्लॅक कॉटन सॉइल कम अक्रॉस टू द फाउंडेशन ऑफ द प्लिन. ओके, सो अ प्लिन प्रोटेक्शन युजली डन बाय पोरिंग अप्रॉक्झिमेट 100 ml ऑफ द प्लिन सिमेंट कॉन्क्रीट अलॉंग द एज ऑफ द बिल्डिंग. The main idea behind this is to prevent the water retention along the edge of the building, thus ensuring its longer life. So that's why we need to be protect the plinth. Okay, next one is a damp proofing course. Okay, why we should provide the DPC course at the plinth level. So DPC course is used to protection from the moisture. DPC course is provided for the protection against the moisture. Dampness may causes the unsightly patches created on the surface of the wall. So that's why we should provide the DPC course at the floor level. Okay, it breaks the continuity of the capillary action which rises from the ground to the wall. Okay, so dampness may causes the softening and the crumbling of the plaster efflorescence may be caused due to the dampness. Timbering and the fitting are the deteriorated due to the dampness. Electric wiring and the fitting may also damage and may causes the short circuiting. The dampness in the building gives the rise to the breeding of the mosquitoes. Hence, waterproofing and the DPC will improve the life of the building and make the hygienic condition in the building for the users. Okay, so that's why we need to be provided DPC course. We need to be provided a DPC course. Okay, so this consists of the introduction of the water repellent member or the damp proofing course between the sources of the dampness and the part of the building to it. The DPC course may consist of the flexible material such as the bitumen, mastic asphalt, bituminous felt, plastic or the polythene sheets or the metal sheets, cement, concrete, etc., etc. A damp proofing course may be provided either by horizontally or the vertically in the floors or walls, etc. The following are the general principles should be kept in mind while providing the DPC. So what are there? That is, the damp proofing course should cover the full thickness of the wall, excluding the rendering. Okay, the mortar bed supporting the DPC should be level and even and should be free from the projection so that the DPC is not damaged. DPC should be laid that the continuous projection is provided. At the junction, at the corner of the wall, the horizontal DPC should be laid continuous. Okay, so DPC should not be kept exposed to the wall surface, otherwise it may be damaged during the finishing work. So that's why we have to provide a DPC, okay, in the building. So we discuss about the material to be used for the waterproofing. So the material, first one is a sand, metal brick bat, waterproofing powder chemicals, giru, we can also said to be, it has a red color, shahabadi tiles, jai socket, cements, these are the material which are used in the waterproofing work. Okay, so there also we need to be use some chemicals in that process. So we can use inorganic compound with a little of percentage of the chlorides and the sulfates, acrylic based compounds, epoxy resins, polysulfide, silicon, tar, bitumen, bitumen based compound. These are the materials which is used in the process of the waterproofing. Okay, so there are two types of methods of the non-conventional waterproofing. First one is a crystalline waterproofing and second one is a cement based polymer coating. Okay, so we can discuss about the crystalline waterproofing. In crystalline waterproofing material is a great way to protect your basement wall from the water and freezing. So it penetrates the porous cavities of the cement which changes the porous concrete into the water solid. It is a great product to use in a wet basement where the water seepage is in problem. A crystalline product contains special additive which react with the byproduct of the cement hydration in the presence of the moisture, initiating a chemical reaction producing a non-soluble crystalline formation only in areas having the presence of the moisture. And it fills all the pores of the concrete and to avoid the capillary action. In this way, we can be provided the waterproofing. Okay, so there are some of the advantages of the crystalline waterproofing. First one is to also it reduce the hairless cracks up to the 0.4 to 0.5 mm width. It also suitable for the structures under the subsoil marine. Due to the non-toxic nature of the material, it can be also be used for the potable water storage areas. And it is very easy to apply, so need to any skilled person, no need to be any skilled person. Okay, so second one is a cement based polymer coating. Okay, so these are the cement based polymers have a high adhesion strength, water resisting,
elevated durability. This is the excellent corrosion protection coating of the thin reinforcement, structural bridge, piles, flyovers, etc. Okay, so this is the fast coating method, and steel members of or a rod can be handled within the 3 or 4 hours after the application of the coating. Okay, so there is a another way of providing waterproofing that is known as a conventional waterproofing methods. So under these there are 3 methods. First one is a brick bat coba, second one is a box type waterproofing, and third one is ejection grouting. So we can discuss about the brick bat coba. So following is the stepwise procedure effectively applied in the treatment of the brick bat coba. So all existing treatment on the roof slab top is initially removed and should be free from the any oil or grease, dust, etc. Okay, so all the non-structural cracks greater than 0.5 mm wide and the construction joints, if any, should be clean. Then the cracks are the filled. Then the layers of the brick bats soak overnight in the water are laid on the layer of the cement mortar, that is proportion 1:4. The gap between the brick bats are generally kept in between the 15 mm to 20 mm. Curing should be start next day, and it should done for the 7 days curing. 7 days curing. Okay, so after 7 days curing, the top surface is finished smooth with a 20 mm thick cement sand mortar 1:4 and mixed with the water proofer. Okay, so in this way we can be provide the waterproofing on the surface of the slab. This system was developed during the initial stages of the flat roof construction with a lime mortar and burn clay brick aggregate. This system involves the laying of the lightweight mortar on the roof and the spreading it to give a gentle slope for the drainage away from the rainwater immediately. The mortar consisted of the lightweight brick pieces as aggregated and ground brick with the lime as binding matrix. Okay, so there are some also limitations of the brick bat coba for waterproofing. Following are the some of the limitations of the brick bat coba waterproofing. First one is there is a possibility of the improper compaction. Second one is the chances of the crack development on the top surface. Third one is if the slab has crack, the retain the water may leak and absorb water may allow the penetration to the slab level. Okay, so these are the, some of the disadvantage, or you can also say that the limitation of the brick bat coba. Okay, so in this way we can be apply the brick bat coba. Brick bat coba madhe apan kay karto, generally apan mortar spread karun tyachyavarti apan vita thevto, and tyachyanantar parat apan tyachyavarti concreting karto kiwa mortar cha layer apply karto. Pavsacha je kay pani asel samjha, je leakage honyachi chances astil te bricks kay karto gatat absorb kartat. Asha paddhatine apan waterproofing करू शकतो. ओके, नेक्स्ट वन इज अ बॉक्स टाइप वॉटरप्रूफिंग. सो बॉक्स टाइप वॉटरप्रूफिंग ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ द अंडरग्राउंड स्ट्रक्चर लाइक बेसमेंट टैक, लिफ्ट पीट, टनल, स्विमिंग पूल, एक्सेट्रा. ओके, सो प्रोसीजर ऑफ द बॉक्स टाइप वॉटरप्रूफिंग, फॉलोइंग आर द प्रोसीजर ऑफ द बॉक्स टाइप वॉटरप्रूफिंग. फर्स्ट वन, इन फर्स्ट स्टेप, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल क्लीनिंग द एक्जिस्टिंग एरिया विथ ब्रशिंग एंड द वॉशिंग. If the crack present, fill it with a rich mix cement mortar on the non-shrink grouts, rendering the 25 mm thick cement plastering 1:5 and fixing the rough shahaba tiles in the staggered pattern with the help of the 20 mm joints in between the tiles. Okay. Next step is to filling the medium size of the aggregate in between the joints and grouting cement slurry admix with the integral plasticizer and the finishing smooth. Okay, the joints are weakest area in between the tiles. Okay, so almost clear of the compaction to be taken while the grouting, rendering average 30 to 40 mm thick cement screed with a proper compaction and the finishing smooth. Okay, curing the same at least for the 7 days, and after the curing, a jointless waterproofing plaster coat is applied and cured. The thickness of the treatment is around 65 to 75 mm. This entire process forms a box around a structure and does not allow any water to seep through or leak from the basement. There are also some limitations for the box type waterproofing. First one, use of the shahaba tiles, joint should be grouted properly or else the leakage would be formed in the through the joints. Okay, it is a labor intensive work for which it requires more time in construction. So these are the, some of the limitation of a box type waterproofing.
ठीक आहे. तर अशा पद्धतीने आपण वॉटर प्रूफिंग त्याच्यामध्ये ॲडॉप्ट करत असतो. नेक्स्ट मेथड आहे इजेक्शन ग्राउटिंग मेथड. ओके, सो इजेक्शन ग्राउटिंग इज द इजेक्शन ऑफ द स्पेशली फॉर्म्युलेटेड सिमेंट बेस्ड मिक्स इन टू द ग्राउंड टू इम्प्रूव इट्स स्ट्रेंथ अँड रिड्यूस द परमेबिलिटी. इट इज यूज फॉर द रिमिडियल ऑर द रिडेव्हलपमेंट ॲप्लिकेशन. सिमेंट ग्राउटिंग टेक्नॉलॉजीज आर द इन्क्रिझिंगली चूजन फॉर द कॉस्ट इफेक्टिव परमनंट सोल्युशन्स. ओके, सिमेंट ग्राउटिंग इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट कॉमनली परफॉर्म बाय द ड्रिलिंग होल्स इन द फाउंडेशन टू इंटरप्ट द ओपन क्रॅक्स, जॉईंट्स, फिजर्स ऑर द कॅव्हिटीज. देन पंपिंग अंडर द प्रेशर बॅलन्स अँड स्टॅबिलाइज ग्राउंड मिक्सेस विथ द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ द सिमेंट वॉटर अँड द ॲडिटिव्स. जशा पद्धतीने आपण इपॉक्सी इंजेक्शन करतो क्रॅक फिल करण्यासाठी, त्याच पद्धतीने आपण इंजेक्शन ग्राउटिंग करतो त्या सर्फेसवरती ज्या ठिकाणी वॉटर प्रूफिंग आपल्याला करायचं आहे. तर ह्या फिगरमध्ये दाखवल्याप्रमाणे, ह्या इमेजमध्ये दाखवल्याप्रमाणे आपण ग्राउटिंग करतो, ग्राउटिंग इजेक्शन करतो. तर अशा पद्धतीने आपण वॉटर प्रूफिंग करतो. हा कन्व्हेन्शनल आणि नॉन कन्व्हेन्शनल अशा दोन्ही पद्धतीने आपण वॉटर प्रूफिंग करतो. ठीक आहे, बाकीचा टॉपिक आपण पुढच्या व्हिडिओमध्ये कव्हर करू. थँक्यू.